Dzień dobry państwu, witamy bardzo.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to welcome you to our today's press conference concerning the presentation of the financial results of the capital group PGNiG for 2016. I'd like to welcome all of you. I'd like to thank you for arriving. I'd like to welcome the representatives of the media. I'd like to welcome the representatives of the financial sector, of the departments of the company. And I'd like to start by inviting you to our next meeting. They will take place on the 14th of March on Tuesday. And during that meeting, we'll present the new strategy of the PGNiG Capital Group. The invitation will be sent to you tomorrow, but already today, please save the date, because we will be very pleased to see you on the 14th and have the possibility to present you a new strategy. Tuesday, the 14th of March, 12:30 in the Intercontinental Hotel. But today, let's focus on the financial results. I'd like to welcome and introduce members of board of PGNiG. I'm the president, Piotr Woźniak. Michał Pieczyk, the CFO. Maciej Woźniak, the vice president for commercial. First, they will present us the financial results. And first, President Piotr Woźniak, then Mr. Pieczyk will present it in more detail, and then the sales will be summed up by Maciej Woźniak, and at the very end we will talk about the plans and perspectives. And again, I'll give the floor to President Piotr Woźniak, and we will finish with a question and answer round. And now I give the floor to Piotr Woźniak. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for coming. We have our fans here, as I see, because I remember all of you from our previous conference. We are very pleased to see you today. Today we have the 8th of March, so I'd like to wish traditionally all the best to all the women, and I'd like to announce a change that took place in the board 2 days ago. Not to say coincident, because we have one additional woman on the board, Magdalena Zagaska, who is the deputy president. And she will be responsible for the QHS sector, so the quality. And we start building, again, our image, not only because we are also starting to build in a more pattern way, or at least try to introduce this year into the activity of our company also the so-called corporate social responsibility, and put a little bit more emphasis on environment protection issues. When it comes to the financial results, I will turn to them in a second. But once again, thank you very much for coming. Very pleased to see our financial results. We show the presentation in a second. So before we move to those results, I have to say that we are pleased to stay on the same level when it comes to the financial results of the capital group and the EBITDA. Last year we had above 6 billion. We have now below 6 billion, 5.97. This is, I think, from our point of view, we can say that we have actually repeated the result from the last year. We are pleased to say that last year we sold 1.5 billion meters of gas more than this year. Why? Because first of all, we had a very cold winter, and we always have problems with that. On the one hand side, we are pleased that the winter is cold because we have better sales results, but then again, we are concerned because we do not like cold winters. But this helped us to a very large extent to increase our sales results. We are talking about 1,300 million of meters gas that was sold. More than 400 million was sold for the very first time to Ukraine. via our transmission place in Hermanowice. And this is a good sign because this market seems to be a market full of perspective. Maybe the margin was not as high as we wanted to, but the level of margin is very acceptable. And we think that we'll have further increase in this direction of sales. As I said, very original direction of sales, because we used to buy and now we used to sell gas to Ukraine. And it seems that we are building a long-term market. This operation is carried out in a very secure way, so there are no transactional problems whatsoever from one or the other side. The third important thing, we have maintained our investment rating at the level of 3.6 minus with a stable perspective. We will, of course, maintain this level for a longer period of time because the perspective for 2018 is also very good. And now I move to the presentation. If I may, I think it's already behind me displayed. Okay, so we observe further changes when it comes to the share of building EBITDA of our particular segments. We used to have the biggest EBITDA built from exploration and production. This year, due to the very strong and high sales, we have a different order, as it's seen on the slide. In comparison, 2015, the biggest EBITDA is built by distribution, and it will be difficult to for other segments to catch up because we're talking about more or less 39%. Then we have sales that exceeded exploration production. Exploration production fell, and then third place, trade and storage, that was placed differently in the last year, number four. So the result, the EBITDA result, is repeated at a level of previous years, as I commented. What is also important to say is that we publish our results just as all the regulations specify to do so, and we do not repeat or we do not present it in any other way, only in that way that is right to do so. So all the results that you see, all the additional numbers are included, and they were really extremely high, and we'll turn to that later, especially when it comes to the exploration and production. We had real high additional assets when it comes to losses and geophysical research. And this because we want to clean our portfolio and our balance and financial results, because we had to catch up in the previous years. And previously, we were able not to proceed. But this year, we wanted to put some order into our portfolio and our company. And now the next slide, I will comment on this very briefly, if you may. I will do it if I may, Mr. President. So exploration and production. We presented in a different order than in the EBITDA. When it comes to exploration and production, this was a difficult year for this segment for various reasons, also due to low raw material prices, because we follow the global market without any hesitation. And the average price of Brent oil that we had last year was $44. As you remember, these are prices from 5-6 years ago, and this is a really low level. And luckily for this segment, oil prices are going up, which is why the production of Brent oil and gas production total dropped, and the numbers that you see, by more or less 4% and 8% annually. When it comes to gas, natural gas, we try and we will think that we will manage to catch up next year, mainly due to the fact that our Norwegian assets will be made accessible and available, but also those assets that we have in land. Next, trade and storage, but President Wozniak will present trade and storage. I have to say that sales are at a record high level. We are talking about 5.7% when it comes to sales, and the increase of sales is, from our point of view, really high. Next year, we do not think that we will have as high level of sales, but it should be at a comparable level. So we're in the next year is 2017, because we are still finishing the fiscal year 2016, because we are talking about 2016, and every time when I say next year, I mean 2017. So actually this year, 2017, we will try to maintain a similar level of natural gas sales. Maybe we'll increase the margin, because the operational margin on high methane gas increased by 2%, and this is an effect of the policy change that we introduced when it comes to retail and bulk sales, that this year was completely remodeled, and the effect, of course, they overlap one another, but still the effects of this approach are visible in the sales. We are talking about the weather effects. So first of all, that due to natural reasons, the demand for gas is higher. And second of all, our methods that have changed, maybe not methods, it's a too big word, but our approach to sales. Then distribution, another segment that generates a important part of the EBITDA. Distribution also has undergone some significant changes. As you remember, we created what will be called the National Distribution Operator, not due to the fact because we like such names, but when it comes to executing this year's plan and the plan of 2017, those plans are really advanced and we are aiming really high. And last year, the level of EBITDA generated by distribution was 2.5 billion zloty as the only single segment that generated this EBITDA. This was an impressive result. It will be not able to repeat it this year. Probably, I'm saying probably, because we all, of course, would like to see it, to see the result at even a higher level. But due to the fact that even more gas is being distributed, and due to the huge work that was done, plus, of course, the fact that we have to catch up, the results of previous year and the connectors of previous year were really numerous, 55,000. This year, we're planning even more, 55,000 of those new connectors, which means we'll have 55,000 new customers for distribution. So the result is impressively high when it comes to the increase, over 11%. And as it was said, over 2,000 kilometers of distribution network, plus a huge investment program. We are talking about 1 billion zloty of investment, 1 billion 100 million, and the plans for this year, for 2017, amount to 1 billion 700 thousand. We have never had such a huge investment budget when it comes to distribution. So far, I wanted only to highlight that these are really realistic plans. The 1.7 billion after 2 months already in 2017, we will, I think, manage to do so. So this is a huge increase when it comes to distribution.
And now when it comes to the generation, first and foremost, it's the heat. We have the Termika company based in Warsaw. And since last year, it was half of the last year, we have two companies dealing with generation and distribution, mainly heat and electricity in the Silesia. This is the energy company Jastrzębie and Przedsiębiorstwo Energetyki Cieplnej. And we really take pride in this investment. We compared the EBITDA from the year 2015-2016, and the increase of EBITDA in both of entities exceeded our forecast or expected results, in spite of the fact that the companies Well, the results were compared only from the second half of the year, because we took over the second company only in August last year, so this was a very successful investment in all aspects. Now, talking about generation, we also take pride in the results of the biggest investment of ours. I'm talking about coal, PGG Group, and we invested heavily in it after long and time-consuming analysis, and we really take pride in it because it means that the company is following the plan and the results of this company, first and foremost, the net result. Well, right now it's the loss, because we're talking about up to 2018, and the business plan included 2016 or 2017, but the loss recorded according to the business plan that was supposed to be incurred by our company, it was incurred, but it was lower by 10% as compared with the original business plan. So we can say that the results generated by us are actually better than planned. And we assume that they are not going to deteriorate, but actually, on the contrary, they are going to be even better. So the business plan is going to be fully completed, as we were assured as investors by PGG. So now the financial results, but perhaps we will move over to the next speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Probably the topic has been exhausted, so just to sum up very briefly, apart from the fact that the revenue from sales dropped by 10%, in our estimation, we believe that we take pride in a solid financial result of our group, and this is good news. In particular, that we were able to offer to all our customers and business partners lower prices of natural gas. And also, moreover, what matters is the temperature factor. I'm talking about, first and foremost, the distribution and generation sector. The average temperature last year, on average, it was lower by 1 degree as compared with 2015. So this means better results of the distribution and generation sector as such. As mentioned previously by the president, the very layout, the composition of the structure of the operation result was changed, increased by the depreciation. The result itself changed only slightly, and also the net result is slightly increased as compared with the last year, and it amounts to 2,200,000,000 Polish zlotych. So now I understand my slide. It all makes sense, ladies and gentlemen. It is good news. I'm talking about the results from sales this year. In the year 2016, we were successful in signing contracts with our strategic recipients, that is, enterprises from the small and medium-sized sector, amounting to more than 13 billion Polish zlotys in total, almost 13 billion, which is exquisite, and it provides excellent customer bases and provides excellent prospects for the foreseeable future. These are medium-term contracts with the previous recipients. They are corrected. Some of them have been renewed, and some new ones have been signed as well. Sales increase, accounting for almost 6%, as mentioned by the president. This is a record-breaking history. For the very first time, we are able to export gas to Ukraine, and we believe that the result is going to be even twice as better in 2017, given the fact that the agreement was already in place last year. And also, we keep analyzing Ukrainian markets meticulously, and hopefully the situation will even ameliorate. And when it comes to retail, in 2016, we were able to gain 74,000 new recipients and new gas outlets. And when it comes to the electricity and selling it within our very new product that is big, a special package, electricity and heat connected and gas, 13,000 recipients it was last year, and this year, the development is even faster. Now, when it comes to German market as such, in 2016, we were able to signed 60,000 new agreements, and we have 60,000 new recipients, individual recipients in Germany, and also our PST company, which operates in Germany, is not only in charge of trading gas with Norway, but also they take care of selling gas to natural customers. Now, when it comes to the stock exchange and our results, as you know from the financial data, it also contributed significantly to our EBITDA result. But also as regards the volume of gas sold by the stock exchange, we believe that it can be calculated as 33% above the obligation that we have to fulfill being on the stock exchange. Now, if I can move to the next slide, talking about the liberalization of the gas market, the biggest landmark when it comes to the sales this year, obviously, it was doing away with the tariffs. I'm talking about doing away or abolishing tariffs for the recipients who are not households. This is the perspective that we have been bracing ourselves, and it was eagerly awaited, and finally it came true, and all our contracts are perfectly prepared for it. In legal terms, all the agreements signed by us for the last several dozen months or so, they include the prices connected with the stock exchange, be that in Poland or somewhere else. And this helps us to do away with some administrative duties, so it is eagerly awaited and welcomed by us this year. The package, electricity and gas, it's going to be extended additionally this year by additional options, and hopefully we will be able to gain even a bigger share of the market this year. And also this year, we want to be able to reserve the capacity in the gas pipe Poland, Norway, Denmark. We keep watching the works of the operators, and we keep awaiting their announcement of the results in the open season. And moreover, we expect an increase in the costs of gas. I'm talking about long-term contracts, since there is an upward trend when it comes to the prices of hydrocarbons. And another event that we keep awaiting and we remain optimistic is the settlement of the arbitration litigation with Gazprom. I'm talking about the price aspect regarding our contracts, and we are waiting it to be settled in the summer this year. So it's not very long. And as you might know, we initiated regular deliveries of LNG from Qatargas, and this cooperation is expected to be continued. The prospects augur well. So this contract and our cooperation, we believe that this is a token of a strong partnership between our companies. And first and foremost, this year we have a brand new office, our trade office in London, and we expect the first transactions to be concluded as soon as this year in this market. So we keep enhancing our competences. Our office is operationally ready, and we expect that this year will show the first transactions on the market when it comes to the liberalization of gas market. I believe that this is it. So right now, over to the President Pietrzyk. Let me just add very briefly, when it comes to the prospects, what seems to be really interesting, the liberalization, what was very awaited by us, I'm not sure if it's going to be helpful or not, but let me just add that this represents two-thirds of our market. One-third it's individual recipients, so it means that the situation will be facilitated, because when it comes to tariffs, they used to be very abstract, not connected with the market, and we had to offer a lot of discounts and rebates in order to remain competitive. And currently, it will be easier for us, following the expected event that is doing away with the tariffs for the recipients who are not households, we will be able to pursue ordinary, regular market segmentation. And if we don't have long-term contracts, very long contracts, we will be able to just be a regular market player according to the terms and conditions pursued anywhere else. If I may just add, talking about the distribution and all kind of investment plans, because it was given a coverage in the media, our distribution, yes, we have signed as many as 150 letters of agreement with the communes in Poland. So the gasification of these areas will come true finally. Of course, this is thanks to the chance offered in the form of the LNG gas. It is already here, delivered to Świnoujście in all the necessary amounts. And the very process will consist in constructing a network of connectors, and we'll be able to transfer LNG to the places where it will be decompressed and delivered to individual networks. So only this year, what we expect is the commencement of as many as 10 investments of this kind. And of course, the dynamics remain really high. So many different municipalities approach us, and so many customers are ready to sign the connection agreements. And this means that apart from the revenues from the distribution, this means in practical terms for us, because this is our ambition, it means that the customers joining our network of distribution will purchase also the gas that we have on offer. So this is also significant from our point of view in this year and in the next years to come. Yes, this channel is really significant for us, and we keep cooperating with the distributor because they also have to bear in mind that the market keeps growing or developing. And when it comes to the regulations, I believe that what seems to really matter, talking about administrative regulations and decisions, I believe that what seems to be really crucial is the appointment by our PSG company, that is our distributor, a special path of obtaining a long-term distribution tariff. Poland is almost in the last position when it comes to short-term changes in the distribution tariff. And this hinders significantly all kind of plans of managing, especially investments. And the Office of Regulating Energy Sector, together with our PSG, in the next months to come, will elaborate a special business model. And in accordance with all the announcements, a special system of long-term tariffs will be launched, which will constitute a significant relief, especially when it comes to managing and planning all kinds of investments, which play a pivotal role in such a big company as ours, especially in such a sizable segment that generated over 2.5 billion of EBITDA. Two flagship investments launched this year. The first one is located in Żerań. This is a special natural gas cogeneration factory. And all the plans, considering almost year-long delay because the tender last year had to be canceled, but right now everything is according to the plan. And the settlement, hopefully, will happen as planned, and no delays are expected. And also Stalowa Wola electricity plant, that's another investment. This process, unfortunately, is taking place very slow, but given all kind of irregularities last year, right now we were able to accelerate the changes, and the procedure has been consolidated. We were able to consolidate the debt, all kind of credit instruments that we are going to use. So we are specifying the schedule of implementation, and the investment is going to be completed as planned after all the problems suffered by us last year. And also what seems to matter, let me think, what can be possibly of interest to you? Obviously, what seems to matter next year, apart from last year, so still I'm talking about 2016, the arbitrary procedure in Stockholm relating to the Jamal contract. The proceedings are in place. There are two proceedings. One was filed by us, one before the European Court of Justice in Luxembourg, and then there is another one as well. And the good news is as follows. It was confirmed only yesterday. We were successful in using the collateral imposed by the Düsseldorf Court and also the European Courts before too, but it was effective by the Düsseldorf Court. We are able to cancel or block long-term auctions on Opal gas line, gas pipe, at least up to April next year. So as a result, Opal as such cannot announce next auctions on a long-term basis. Because this is according to the network code stipulations, and they will not be able to announce long-term tenders or auctions not exceeding more than 50%. So we were able to hamper this Gazprom privilege thanks to the legal proceedings. We had to appeal against the court of the first instance. Of course, we will keep continuing our efforts, and we expect the court to give its decision next year in the main case, because the collateral is only a temporary provision in both of these proceedings. So this is something that has been of our focus recently, and it involves a lot of net effort, because never before did we have to act like that when it comes to international arbitration proceedings. This is something you can obviously follow, and we will keep you informed directly. Obviously, it's worth following the case. Several important aspects for us. We keep repeating all the time that there are two aspects that matter most. First and foremost, we have to comply with all kind of competition rules internationally, also in Germany, and also energy, safety and security of the entire country. This is of top priority for us, and we are doing our utmost so that it is preserved, especially in the gas sector, so that the right level of security is maintained. I believe this is it on my part. And questions, perhaps? If you do have any questions, we are welcome to answer all of them.
Dziękuję.
Andrzej Kublich. Andrzej Kublich, Gazeta Wyborcza. So I have a couple of questions, of course. So the first question, due to the fact that we still have tariffs, you filed a motion for the tariff of a retail operator, and the proceeding should be ongoing because the recent tariff lasts only up to this month. So what is the case here? Because in the previous fact, the Energy Regulation Office, knowing that gas prices are increasing, it lowered the tariff, and you also introduced, well, a new rule, namely the latest as possible. So how does it actually look, and what will be especially important when it comes to the one-third of recipients starting from April when you talk to the Energy Regulation Office? The second fact, the second issue, Ukraine. The export is getting lower, and how would you comment on that? And what Naftohaz says, that Gazprom was against the development of this connection, this extension of this connection. Will this have any influence on your further plans concerning your cooperation with Ukraine? Because they are broader, because it's not only about the gas pipeline, but also the commercial exchange. The third thing, is Polymax. PGNiG Technology was one of the shareholders as part of the consortium, and it took over Polymax. And Polymax, as you will know, has not exceeded all, has not executed all road investments. And how will those losses be? Will influence the financial results of the whole group, especially the financial results of PGNiG Technology, because this company is responsible for a number of strategic pipelines. How will this be managed? How will be how the risk will be managed? And the last case, LNG. Could you tell us maybe when you plan the first and the next, the first this year and next in the history, purchase of LNG for our market? When it comes to the detailed, the retail tariff, yes, of course, we are in the process of preparing a new tariff, and the motion has been filed already. And the president of the Energy Regulation Office has the right to set the tariff at a level that suits the office best, and in our motions we do communicate it clearly, and this time we see reasons to increase this tariff for the retail sector, so for households. And such a decision when it comes to tariffs, and this decision was something that we expected. When it comes to Hermanowice and Ukraine, yes, we do have information that the Russian side does not like the fact that the Ukrainian-Polish connection is established and is developing, and this is a, well, a situation where two countries have an independent energy policy. We are planning to develop our energy network, and it's impossible for us to be under the influence of a third party because there are no possibilities whatsoever to interfere in our cooperation. We're talking about a two-side cooperation between one country that's part of the European Union and another country being part of the energy family if there will be a necessity to extend this energy connection even more. I do not see why a third party should interfere. When it comes to the spot LNG market, this is how the market really looks, namely that when a transaction on this market is found, we will inform you about this automatically, but it's difficult to foresee it now. And that is why our commercial office in London was created, in order to monitor this market really thoroughly, and every single good piece of news and possibility to have a higher margin LNG is executed. And you are informed about this, so it's difficult to foresee this for me, but we do expect such transactions to take place, and we'll inform you about this. And now Polymax. When it comes to Polymax, we are pleased that we invested in Polymax, first of all, because the increase of value and capitalization of Polymax shows that we really made the right decision. What was the question again? When it comes to the financial risks due to the takeover of the company, how will this influence the financial results? What's your plan for crisis management? Because Polymax has a really rich history when it comes to faulty investments and financial management. Well, of course, I did not talk with Minister Adamczyk because not. And when it comes to the liabilities that are present due to the investments that have not been executed for the general direction of roads and motorways, we did not see this case when we made the due diligence analysis of the net value of Polymax together with our companies. And for the time being, which is why there were no write-downs last year or this year. This year we made the transaction, so last year we did not need any such write-downs. But this case that you mentioned will be monitored, of course, by us. And pardon my French, but we will not come up with any original solutions, because when a write down on net value will be necessary, we will do it, of course. During our due diligence evaluation that we started last year, it turned out that such a threat is not accurate, not visible, and we made it not only ourselves, but we also cooperated with professionals and experts in order to make this due diligence analysis, and such a threat was not mentioned. Having this in mind, having the opinion of experts in mind, we executed the investment, the decision, or when the decision was made, we also made the following decision, that the investor from our side would be PGNiG technology due to a similarity of due to a business similarity, and for a certain period of time such an investment model will be upheld. We do not see any risk when it comes to that. We don't have also any additional information. We'll wait how the situation develops. When we look at the capitalization results of Polymex, it is really optimistic. This value increase, we are talking about even slightly below 10 zloty, means that we made the right decision. So that would be my comment on to your question. But we will not make any special communique. When we have any additional write-downs, we will book it in a typical standard way. Teresa Wójcik, Business Alert. I have two questions. Unfortunately, I have more, but I'll save them for Tuesday, because more about strategy and not what has already happened or what is currently. My first question, could you describe for the time being how will the supplies look like for our LNG harbor? Where is our advantage actually? How many spot supplies we have, and what's the evaluation of this project? And the second question concerns not maybe PGNiG itself, but the situation on the gas market. What's the share of private companies on this market, and do you know what is the situation when it comes to the gas purchase? Where do they buy this gas, and at what price? Do they have any additional discounts or extra prices when it comes to the price competition? Of course, retail supplies are the matter of the question. When it comes to the terminal and our planned supplies, we are talking about our contracts, and this year we will receive, according to the agenda, 11 Q-Flex ships from Qatar. We are working really intensively in order to optimize our LNG portfolio, our LNG supplies. I cannot give you any further details, but in the nearest time I think we'll have additional information concerning this topic. I also answered a similar question previously when it comes to the spot market. As I said, the transaction that are being planned, plus bring the gas to Poland, this might happen at any moment, but we also consider a situation where our commercial office in London will buy cargo and then sell it even when the ship is already on sea, because this is what trading is all about. The transactions executed by the office in London will not necessarily mean that we will have a delivery straight to Poland. When it comes to the gas import market, we know, of course, that such concessions for gas purchase abroad are issued in numbers exceeding hundreds. So the activity of those entities is drastically different from a real and big competition from our point of view, or a visible competition. Here we are talking about only a couple of companies on the market, and we do expect, of course, that we will see big European players on the market. of course, all of us, the new players and the old players, have to work accordingly to the Act of Law on supplies. That means that you need to have stored supplies when you import gas, especially in the context of crisis situations. So we are open to the competition. There are, of course, voices that those regulations are really difficult and complex from a logistic point of view. And due to the fact that the new Act of Law ensured such a possibility, we offered this storage service on the market, which means that we will completely 100% comply with this Act of Law, as also does our competition that is active on the import segment, which at the same time allows us to put the important amount of money to execute our investments. And this service, from our point of view, is very competitive, and it will be always cheaper than storing our supplies abroad, not in Poland, which also is mentioned in the Act of Law. This service is constructed in such a way so that it is really profitable to, based on the agreement, to have this storage in Poland. When it comes to prices, the number of concessioned companies that has the concession to sell inland dropped, but only slightly. We do not have statistical data that could confirm this, but we will, of course, issue such a document with the information. You can also turn to the president of the energy regulation market, because it is an objective document. And when it comes also to prices, please bear in mind that, of course, we and our competition sell our products as part of bilateral transactions, but the gas obligation is similar to the electricity market, because the energy obligation is up to 50%. And this was exceeded on the commodity stock exchange, over 30% that is being sold on the market, which is why access to a competitive price and various products, long-term, short-term, or mid-term, is very different and can be evaluated differently on the market, which is why I think we have reached a normal level when it comes to the stock exchange. Of course, in other countries, or in the majority of other countries, this energy obligation is lower. But due to the fact that our stock exchange exceeds this level, and we also do exceed this obligation, this does not result from the fact that we love the stock exchange, but only because due to the fact that it's profitable for us and for the receivers. You can comment differently on that from our point of view, but we see a huge demand on this, and this does not mean that we have exceeded it only this year, because we have exceeded this level also last year, and we should see no complaints when it comes to this system, because this ensures a high fluency of our market in Poland.
Kubik.
Wojciech Jakubik, Business Alert. I have a question regarding two questions. President Woźniak mentioned that your intention is to double the sales to Ukraine. What are the exact numbers? How much were we able to sell last year? What about this year and next year? And then secondly, what about the arbitration procedures? Is it the settlement or the decision by the court? The second question will be answered by the president. When it comes to Ukraine, we sold almost 300 million cubic meters last year, and let me remind you that the contract lasted from August till December. This was the period of transactions, so this is pure maths, and our cooperation is going to be successful. So in future, so we hope to double this result, although we keep watching this market very closely. We keep penetrating it. We believe that what is the limit is the capacity of Hermanowice output, and of course we need to also be able to have access to it through auctions. Let me remind you that right now this out that helps you to export the gas. I'm talking about almost half a billion cubic meters. That's the potential. But of course, all the terms need to be negotiated. So I believe that this is quite feasible to say that we want to double the plan. That is the plan of almost 800 million cubic meters. Yes, it is very interesting. We keep watching the Ukrainian market very carefully. Currently, we cannot do better than half a billion cubic meters because that's the capacity of Hermanowice. But this is the objective of our sales department, so this is our intention. We want to double it, but perhaps I could be even more optimistic. I believe that what matters, what should be commented, is that we have no problems whatsoever in settling our transactions and returns and documents. Everything keeps going well. It's like a textbook example. And now, secondly, what was the second question about? Yes, what we expect is the ruling, the decision of the court. Hopefully it will take place in the summer, perhaps the beginning of autumn this year. Originally, we are expecting it to take place in July, but probably right now it will happen in August. So hopefully before winter and the gas season, we will have the court's ruling regarding this case, and it all augurs well. And even if there is a slight delay going to take place, perhaps it will happen just 1 or 2 weeks later. But it all goes well, and hopefully there are not going to be any significant delays in the proceedings. So I could risk a statement that we will be able to notify all of you about the ruling in August. It all goes according to the plan. In April, the hearings begin before the court. Marcin Lumartowicz, Bloomberg News. I have two questions. The first one is directed to President Pietrzyk. At the conference, you mentioned that when it comes to the dividend proposal, you are going to include in it the fact that last year a buyback took place. So what does it really mean? Does it mean that the proposal is going to be lower by the buyback? How are you going to make it up to your shareholders? And what about this year? Will there be any buyback? And now, secondly, about EDFs. I would like to know what your participation is going to be in the EDF company following the negotiations. What is your estimation? Or perhaps Panitermika will receive one of the electricity plants and they will be the operator of one of the EDF electricity plants. When it comes to the dividend itself, currently it's not going to change in accordance with the current company strategy. We want to pay out up to the 50% of the net result to our shareholders. When it comes to the transactions that took place last year, I'm talking about the transactions amounting to in total 645 million Polish zlotys. It was directed to all the shareholders, and we had to state that there was no attractively enough acquisition proposal last year, and we suffered from this. Actually, too much money, basically. So for us, it's a form of paying out the profit for shareholders. Nevertheless, the final decision belongs to the general meeting of shareholders, and the management board can only have our own proposal. It has not been adopted yet. But are you going to include this last year's buyback? What was it all about? Could you just clarify it, please? Obviously, we cannot include it. As I said, we are going to take this into consideration. As we argumented last year, the money was paid out in the form of the stocks buyback because there was just too much of them available. But let me repeat it once again. The amount of the dividend is going to be specified by the general meeting of shareholders. And what about EDF? Right now, this transaction is in the pipeline together with the entire transaction. PGE is the leader of the consortium. And so far, we had a group of investors cooperating with one another. And this transaction, according to all the specifications, does not provide for an individual purchase of the assets. We are going to acquire all the assets in total. And what happens next, it's hard to predict, because the contract has not been concluded on binding terms. We have to take the opinion of other investors into consideration. And let me repeat that once again. PGE is the leader of the consortium, and we have to cooperate with all the investors. You asked about one particular electricity plant. I cannot indicate anything in particular. I cannot indicate any individual investors or any individual asset elements. Right now, this is at the level of 40%, if my memory serves me well. No, excuse me, it's 30%. So what has been declared is the level of 30%. Yes, indeed. But it has not been allocated on an even basis, but it was increased by 5%. 2 times 30% and 2 times 20%, that's the allocation. I'd like to inquire about the Opel gas line network. Apart from the court proceedings, do you take any diplomatic actions so that the other party is convinced about your opinion? We have the Chancellor Gabriel today visiting Warsaw, who is the main supporter of enhancing cooperation with Gazprom. So what are your expectations? Will Opel be included in the discussions, and are you willing to participate in the talks? Well, yes, we do know that the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Germany is here, and that he supports the cooperation, but we are not going to manifest strongly our opinion because we are not diplomats ourselves. I can imagine that this topic, the topic of Opal, talking about not us but the Republic of Poland, as you know, that this is a separate proceeding by the Republic of Poland. So, of course, as I imagine, this topic is going to be touched upon at such a high administrative level. Obviously, it is of top priority. We have did our homework, and we keep notifying about the developments in this case, the case that was filed by us directly. And of course, the administration will do as they please, so I am not going to touch upon the diplomatic efforts because this is not our thing. I'd like to ask you about the perspectives of further development in terms of quality and quantity, and also I'm talking about takeovers in the sector of resources. What are your plans, and in one geographical regions? And thirdly, Stalowa Wola, could you clarify the issue? What is the schedule of launching and implementing this investment? I'll try to do my best, to the best of my memory. When it comes to the plans for the next year, I would like once again to invite you to the conference dedicated to our strategy that will take place next week, because we keep working on our plans for the next 5 years, and this schedule is to include the year 2000 and probably 26. So future, yeah, it's going to take place next Tuesday, and then I will tell you more about it. Let me invite you to this conference once again. Now, ECSW, I can say that the very investment and the agreement, I'm talking about all the creditors and future creditors, those who maintain the crediting. Right now, we are at the so-called standstill. So our creditors, the banks offering financing for us, do not take any action. And we need to reach an agreement as regards the future financial structure. Probably the deadline is the end of March to do so. Yes, the current structure of financing, external financing, these are free banks. And we also have the European Investment Bank here. And it's 1,100,000 more than that Polish zlotys. So right now, we are planning to change the formula of financing. And this is going to take place on a corporate basis. We assume that by the end of June, we are going to conclude a brand new agreement when it comes to financing the group of banks, that is at least two banks. We already have the banks' declarations as regards their willingness to participate in this brand new financing. And concluding this contract will help us to initiate new agreements binding for us and partners, talking about supplies of gas and electricity. And also, I have to comment on one more thing. Due to a number of total irregularities for the last 2 years, almost the last 3 years, regarding this project, we had to resign from a very comfortable formula owing to a lot of risks. I'm talking about the quasi-project financing. And we had to take over this investment and use the balance, which is a burden for the company, of course. If it is managed in the right way, we wouldn't suffer so much. And the investment would be completed on time. So that's it. We were forced to change the formula, which was a burden for our balance. We had no other alternative. And also, we just finished the inventory of the construction site in terms of quality and quantity. I believe it was in January. I'm not sure, but both of them were completed. And right now, a tender was announced for the renovation of this total construction disaster that was in place. It was just a total disaster, so right now it all has to be done once again from scratch. It's not very complicated, it's not very expertive, the channel of cooling water, but it is just essential. So we have to do it once again from scratch, and we have to keep up with the schedule. We did have some problems with concluding the tender, but right now the cooling water channel is under construction, and hopefully anytime soon this tender is going to be concluded. I'm talking about both Tauron and other partners. They wish to complete this investment cooperating with the Polish energy network companies, who are willing to have this brand new source of power in that very region, owing to the needs, given the fact that the needs are really big. We decided to complete this investment, although at the very beginning we kept wondering whether it's all worth the effort, it is worth giving so much financial outlay so that it can be restored to its full operations. Do you have any other questions, perhaps? I believe you have one more question from Mr. Kublik. One is about a contract with Qatar. Last year, what about stakeholder pay? Was it the previous agreement regarding Qatar disposing of some part of the ships because the number was insufficient? And the calculations, what was the balance for the PGNiG? And secondly, what about the operations of the insurance company? What is its share of the entire portfolio? Talking about the Qatar contract, first and foremost, the agreement, Prosit-Krat, which allowed us for a partner cooperation with Qatar and help in financing the cargo that could not reach Poland, because we did not have the terminal completed. It was successful, but the cooperation was completed even earlier because the terminal started operating 2 months before. But I must say that we are really happy about the cooperation with Qatar because they treated us well. We were their priority partner, and the total cost of redirecting of ships equaled almost zero, which means that we did not incur any loss whatsoever. So I must say that it all went well. Awaiting the terminal right now, what we do is just to receive cargoes. So yes, the Qatar Gas Company and the cooperation with them, it was really excellent. And I don't mean to boast about it. I must say that yeah, at the end of the day, it's $13 billion thanks to the securing transactions that were used. At the end of the day, the result amounted to approximately 10 million Polish zlotys. And given the delay in contracts and no physical opportunity of receiving gas, I believe that we as the company have to really appreciate our partner because this is an exceptional partner and we really value our cooperation. Let's bear in mind that in total it was 16 ships, each of them worth $30 up to $40 million dollars. So the cost of our cooperation was just negligible. And the insurance company, that was my second question. The insurance company keeps developing as planned. We keep taking over next agreements once they expire. I'm talking about the obligations with other insurers. And so far, the entire group was serviced by one broker. So right now, it all goes through one broker, insurance broker. What seems to be interesting, the insurance company already recorded the first damage or loss. If no, maybe it should be the case. Why? Because, I had a small car accident in the parking lot. So this is what I'm talking about. So we are going to calculate it on our own account. There are no delays in plans. It is building the entire portfolio. Of course, it will take time. Not owing to the fact that we keep taking over the portfolios successively. Also, we slowly but gradually build our competence. I'm talking about the sales, but also the very insurance technique, and also when it comes to the liquidation. So it all takes place very slowly. But this is the industry that doesn't enjoy being rushed. We are taking it slow, as the regular insurance company could do. Piotr Maciążek, Energetyka 24, we mentioned Qatar, we mentioned so many other things. So an old story. Will there any actions be taken as regards renegotiating this contract? Because in my understanding, the price of oil right now is relatively low. So the problem is of moderate nature, but it may bounce back following the changes in the prices of oil in future.
This will be a very short answer, but please don't think that it would be rude. Well, the price of oil is significantly increasing. First of all, second of all, if there will be any changes introduced to the contract or will be a new contract, we'll inform you about this. Of course, first of all, the Warsaw Stock Exchange and you will be informed about this. Thank you. But we are constantly doing everything we can in order to optimize our portfolio when it comes to those products that we receive from as liquefied, but also those that we receive from pipelines. And one final question. Let me come back to the issue of international pipelines. As we know, we have the case with Opal, but in Germany, Gazprom, and actually German-Russian companies are dealing currently with the fact of preparing a new pipeline along the Polish border. There are even some problems with environment protection issues, and the speaker of the West Pomeranian Voivodeship turned to the central authorities. And though maybe PGNiG knows something about this, and maybe you are trying to contract in any case. Well, not only the intervention of the Marshal of the Voivodeship, but also due to the general need, we are active and we are in constant contact with the local authorities. When it comes to this case, we have also among the board, we have also a method to monitor and react to this project of building a pipeline alongside the Polish border. And of course, we also monitor the case of environment protection. We will use those instruments if it's necessary. We are concerned that those allowances that were given in the case of the previous project, we either oversaw this or it was being done so quickly that we were not able to see it on time, unfortunately. And we have to get more information about it, because if the procedure was infringed here, we will react to that, of course, because this is our direct neighborhood. This is our internal energy market where no borders are visible whatsoever. But in this case, we will not only monitor this, but we are also preparing for further work in order to introduce concrete steps, and without details, but I have to say that local authorities are very important in this case, regardless what voivodeship we are talking about, especially if this is a border region. We'll work together with them. And last question. One additional question comes to the coal sector. PGNiG or PGNiG Termika is ready to give more money for the capitalization of PGG together with KPH. Okay, I did understand your question. So the question is good, because at some point after the first investment in PGG, the one and only up to now, we were concerned about the results that we saw. But at the end of the day, at the end of the year, PGG said that it had a smaller loss than in the business plan, because the business plan was rather conservative, which is why we are very positive about this. And if there will be an additional transaction investment, maybe we will think about this additional capitalization. But it was not my question, so please ask the question again. Will you take part in the capitalization of PGG, and are we ready to do it? We are ready to capitalize many things, but this requires a decision of the board. We'll analyze the PGG results, and as I said, up to now we are maybe not that positive, but because we do not like to see losses whatsoever, but we think that we will manage to do it. When it comes to KHV, we have not received the results yet. We'll analyze the sector. What also influences our way of thinking when it comes to the decision if to invest or not, we are looking closely at coal forwards. So the stock transactions, and they stopped, and they have an increased tendency at a level of 70 million per ton, standard ton. So this is a pretty good result. We expected it to be different, because 3 months ago the forwards were at a level of 73, and it's still the same level. But at the beginning of the year, we expected that the coal forwards would drop drastically due to the fact that huge coal mines are being relaunched in China. In addition to that, we also had negative market prognosis from Australia, plus cold winter. But it turned out that the coal forward stopped at a level of $70 or even $83 to the end of the year. We even looked at it closely yesterday, but this is how it looks for now. It's really attractive. I'm talking, of course, about energy coal. So we are really looking closely at commodities market everywhere where we are involved actively. So there will be no yes or no answer because we are looking at it and monitoring very closely. And I wanted to ask one additional question. Some time ago, Deputy Minister Kurtyka said that when it comes to the decisions of the European Court of Justice, we'll have those by the end of February. Do you know anything else apart from what you've already said when it comes to Opal? Well, it was a misunderstanding because we have two decisions we are waiting. The first one when it comes to the we're expecting for two decisional cases that we mentioned previously. The main proceeding is the main proceeding, of course, and we have stated that we want to cancel the decision of the European Commission concerning exactly that it is. We want to have it written that it is null and void. The decision of the European Commission to give the exclusive right for transmission to Gazprom. This is the main proceeding, and at the same time we filed a motion so that up to the time when this main case is solved, the right institution, in this case the European Court of Justice, and the previous case the court itself, hold the execution of this decision up to the moment when this main case is solved. And this was a misunderstanding because maybe Deputy Minister Kurtyka expected that the European Court of Justice will decide about those two cases, but nothing happened. We are still talking about a temporary hold of this decision. But due to the fact that the deadline is over and there's, of course, tough agenda, plus additional requirements, and no one can avoid this, plus additional regulation of capacity allocation mechanism, the so-called CAM code, the deadline for introducing the long-term option for this year are already gone and will be not revoked because it's impossible to do so. So up to the end of next year, March, April, the long-term auctions for transmission for those who are interested will be or cannot be announced. And this was the answer of the European Commission for the to the question of Jacek Sariusz-Włoski that mentioned exactly this and asked the Commission. The Commission said that up to the day when this decision is made not void, the further proceedings on this pipeline are not possible to be executed. And when it comes to the direct and indirect transmission of powers, the deadline is over. So up to March next year, the German side, I'm talking about the German operator, cannot announce an auction for the 15-year long-term period of transmission. So this year, when it comes to this case, is safe. Yesterday was the last day, so we had a quite nervous day to listen whether or not something would be announced. This mechanism would not function if the court would cancel our decision. Then, of course, everything would go as we would not like it to see. But due to the fact that this deadline was passed yesterday, we have 1 year of additional time in order to lead the case as we want to. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. In a moment, we will have an opportunity to talk with the representatives of the board. Once again, we'd like to invite you to a meeting on Tuesday where we'll present you the new strategy. We'll send you the invitations and you'll find further details. 12:30, Tuesday, 14th of March. Thank you very much for today.